Should be ready in an hour. Be 14 bucks parts, 27 bucks labor.
These damn things. I should have worn the flats.
Never had any trouble with them.
These damn things.
Poor sods. It's a right mess down there.
Yeah, and our man De Silva's down in it.
Maybe the intel he's gathered can shed some light on these sleepwalkers.
A good bet it will. Agent De Silva's gonna teach us what these things already know. How to get in there.
Agent De Silva, come in.
Welcome to the Bureau.
It's Carter.
XCOM.
You there?
Classified. So, we saw the beginning there.
Agent De Silva's last transmission was within half
speaking.
A mile of here. That's the best we've got, I'm afraid.
If we can't find him, we're gonna have a hell of a time getting into that tower.
Alright. So, this is the second video of the Bureau XCOM Declassified, and I'm going to take a similar approach. The first one was called the Bureau Player Pass Vista View Boss Fight, maybe? Again, I'm going to focus on how this level is laid out. We will think about the player path, how the art is working, in conjunction with the level design and blockout, how dead ends are done well as poorly, how we come into significant events in the mission progression, and again combat layout, since this is a cover-based combat style game. Oh, he's lighting up a smoke. Didn't realize that. Stand here idle enough, you light up a smoke. So one of the big things is this is our target. This is our focal point. This is our goal. We are trying to get to this alien base, which has a dominating presence, which is very cool. If you didn't watch my first video, I made comments on, you know, this game is pretty fun. It has a lot of mediocre moments, a lot of bad moments, but also a lot of good moments. The package itself is just a little mediocre because there's a lot of uneven quality and decisions in art and design and all kinds of stuff. But this is really nice to have this here. So let's pay attention to this road here. This we have the smashed car creating our blocked dead end, which is okay. At least it looks somewhat natural. We know this chaos has ensued in this world since the alien invasion. There's signs here, there's a fence, the crashed angle, the street looks like it continues. Looks pretty good. I wouldn't give it an A, I'd give it a B, B minus. Looks a little empty out there. Looks a little staged in a bad way. So, but the street is not just flat though. Notice how it curves upwards, which is very good. I always stress, let's not make everything flat like building Lego on your kitchen table. It curves upwards. You have this nice restaurant spinning sign, this dominating restaurant here on the side. We have cars to take cover. We have new weapons. I would say new weapons, but ammo in case we need ammo. It's not all flat and flush. You know, the buildings jut out, and there's things like this here. We have a little parking lot, garbage. Behind it, we have more cars. You can see behind it, gives it depth, makes it feel like there's life. Ooh, there's bullet holes. It's a nice touch. Here's a little detail of bad art. You can see the inside this restaurant is a 2D replication of 3D, and it would look fine if we never got closer than this, but the fact that I can get this close really starts to make it break down. You can see the textures of these, what we call these blinds or shades, are breaking down, getting all fuzzy, and there's supposedly a dead person in there, and it looks all kind of hokey, but I kind of like it. I kind of looking in there and seeing the whole scene. Definitely feels it makes format. Definitely makes it feel like it's more life, there's more going on in this world, but you probably shouldn't be able to get any closer than this. cracks in the texture and the illusion starts to break down. Alright, we continue up. We have a burned. Is that a person or an alien? We have an alien, burned up, blown up car. The style of the houses and or I should say the architecture looks really nice. It's got that 60s, 50s vibe.
Don't get too comfortable, Carter. We're still seeing some patrols down there.
Copy.
Alright, so we've curved up the road. We get to this blockade, which is staged decently. More dead aliens. Looks pretty cataclysmic. And from this point, we can jump over. And this is where the action begins. This fight might take some time. We'll see how it goes. This one could be kind of hard because I like to throw lots of grenades. And let's start the action. Who should I take out first? Ooh, I should save my powers for when the drop pods start to arrive. So, let's take out this guy first.
That one there.
Oh, bad shooting. He's gonna show. He's already. Buddy's already dying. Alright, this is where we gotta take some action. Let's get a grenade out. Alright, it's time to do a little healing. Get a little stretch to
walk it off.
Stretch to D. Let's target the drop pod.
Attack!
My critical
taking
strike
aim.
Guy.
Take cover!
Hit it hard!
He's already down.
Coming around. Okay.
Focus on that one.
This one's mine. Set up some cover.
And do I have combat stims? Combat stims. Let's do
shield
it.
Going up.
Stims.
Activating stims.
Gotta take out this drop pod before more reinforcements arrive. Oh, bug! Oh, that's not a bug. Holy crap. Come on, take that thing out! Can I heal again? No, I can't heal. What else can we do here? Nothing. Oh, jeez. Oh, jeez!
You okay, Commander?
Thought I was a goner.
Uh-oh, I might be in trouble here. I accidentally ran for it. There we go.
Taking cover.
Heal!
Healing engaged.
And what's next? I think we could use a shield here. No more dying.
Shield that spot! Shield up! Take cover! Grenade!
Let us target the sniper. You up there.
Hit it hard!
Get down. Take an aim.
I think I've gotten rid of these grenade happy fellows.
Shield is down. Watch out, more coming!
Shooting the back seat of the car. Not a good idea.
What do we do?
What do we do? Push back.
Commander, you're wounded.
Keep the pressure on him. Lifting. Focus on that target.
It's mine.
Come on, hurry, hurry.
Oh! Taking damage. Alright, I think we got this under control. Let's finish this off and we can check out this layout of this.
Moving into cover.
Nice.
Got one!
All targets down.
Okay. So during that firefight, I couldn't talk a whole lot. I didn't want to die and have to restart. And I don't want to switch. No, I don't. So as we approach this first encounter here, it's pretty intense from the get-go. And it's only intense because they throw grenades like crazy. So when we started the fight here, we had our first enemies walk across. As soon as we engaged them, I think after we killed maybe one or two, the next wave of enemies approached. They were in a drop pod. They come in, they drop, they immediately spawn four or five more enemies. So the key to this, and what I'm ignoring here, is we have our awesome focal point. Where is our target? Where are we going? It's not at the end of this mission, but a few more missions in front of this, we start getting closer and closer to this destination point. So the whole time we head up the road, we're looking right at this beautiful giant base of the aliens. Very awesome. So we get to the second wave, we kill off the second wave, and then we have a third wave appear in the parking lot. Now pay attention to the player path here. We come up here, we take cover, we engage this way. As we move forward, we take out the drop pod, we engage the enemy here. Now we have to do this hard right, which I think is really cool, and go into this park, used car lot, but a car lot. We take cover on this large wall, which is great. You could go straight to the car dealership if you want. But this hard right turn is great. You've got the spinning sign, you've got the little alien on top, which adds some nice comedic value to it. Do we have a sniper over here? Where's the sniper rifle? I thought you could pick one up over here. Nope, don't have it. So as we head to this point, we have more cover points, which the whole game is occupied with all kinds of cover points. You've got telephone booths, mailboxes, these are alien walls that are set up, cars, very well done. So the fact that these are at 90 degrees and these are at 90 degrees perfectly parked gets a little old. I'd like to get things off the grid if I had my way. This one's curved, but again, why is it kind of just curved and perfectly parked? Couldn't it be better set up with a few more details so it looks a little more haphazard, like somebody crashed there or something? So this is great. Coming up here, seeing your destination, fighting the aliens, having to turn and head into this car lot is just great. And here's a nice little touch. We're always looking for little touches to make your game more interesting. Obviously the art, this sign is great. The flickering lights, it looks great. It's designed very well. The architecture, everything looks good. And here's a nice touch. Yay, let's shoot the balloon. That's good stuff. Things like that are great to add to your games if you have time. Oh, but then it sinks through the world. Oh, it's too bad. Now, if we're in this parking lot, I keep saying parking lot, it's really a car sales lot. Looks pretty good. So when you have to set up cover points like this, it's tough. You're trying not to make everything look like a wall or a box on a grid. Which we all know playing Gears of War, if you haven't played Gears of War, you need to, if you're into cover shooters. It was really the cover shooter that, what's the word? I say perfected it. Really made a game that did it really, really well and made a whole game out of it that everybody wanted to play and was really, really good. Some people debate that with other games, but it was really one that broke the mold. And there was definitely other games that used cover shooting. But Gears of War is really the big one that really kind of broke the mold, and everybody after that point wanted to add cover shooting to just about everything. So having this forklift load crates into this, you can climb up here. This is awesome. This is all level design stuff you got to think about. How do we approach this? The fact that this front of this building's curved is great. I mean, getting away from everything being on a grid is always good. So as we approach up here, another big game-wide decision that's throughout the game is they have these flashing textures, which is really nothing more than a decal or something of that sort on top of a particular area or object that's just cycling through, you know, moving the UVs of a texture to make it flash. But it really does work. I don't find it offensive. I don't find it too gamey. I think it's perfect. And if we investigate around here, you know, there's plenty of space back here. It doesn't feel like, you know, this is walled off right here and we're enclosed in a ridiculously small space. There's more space back here. And when we advance to this next area, you're going to see that we go out the back. So I'm a big fan of this mission. It's very well done. Now we're going to enter the door. And voila, we're in a car dealership. Art's very good in here. Lighting's great. Looks like something out of the 50s, 60s. Looks really good. There's our little alien guy again. So again, we have a mission. We have to keep people occupied. We have to draw them through our space. We have to progress. Keep the player moving and interested in what they're doing. And I'm really going to have to go get that perk for that guy because it's driving me crazy. Let's see. What's he going to get? He's going to get diversion or invisibility cloak. Oh, diversion's so much better. Yes, we'll take diversion.
Create a projection duplicate of the recon agent, drawing fire and distracting enemies. Yeah, too much damage will destroy the projection.
Cool stuff. Alright, so back to the car dealership. Now I'm trying to keep my player interested. Now pay attention to the architecture. If you're a level designer, there's no way you're going to lay this out unless you really pay attention to a real dealership. The way these walls meet here, the placement of the coffee machine, table, how these offices are laid out. There's no way you can just imagine this and lay this out appropriately just by guessing, unless you have an amazing memory. So we have these little, whoops, wrong button. We have these little notices around here, notes that we can pick up, keep us going, start telling a deeper side of the story, let people read that. Make sure you wash your hands so you don't catch the alien flu. Keep a smile on your face, but try not to breathe too deep. So a level designer's gig could be, definitely would be adding to some of this. Hopefully your team will have one designer writer that's writing these things and perfecting them, but coming up with ideas is definitely part of your job as a level designer, mission designer. You want to add to the story, you want to add your own funny twists, you want to add little tidbits that might be in the mission that the head writer's not aware of, because when you write a mission, it's all about fun gameplay. You may be veering off, you may be following the story, but you will be doing things that make the game fun, make it interesting, and you need to add deeper elements for your mission to do that. Head over here, we have some ammo, a pistol, ooh, a little turntable. There's another note over there I didn't read. So I like how we come in here and we don't just walk straight through this door and keep walking straight. You know, we go into the offices because it's very inviting and we want to check out what's going on there. We see the flashing ammo, we go in and investigate. We have to come over here, take this, and we do not have to go in here as well. So as we come around here, and take this hard right, if these guys get out of my way, this is our final destination. But there's another room. A little exploration, a little extra investigation for the player is always good as long as you don't overdo it. It's gonna play. Just collected 1-6 customer. I don't hear any audio. We get to view out onto the streets, get a little street scene.
The whole town is infected.
A little poorly staged, but I'm not gonna argue too much. People wandering around in their zombie-ish state. Can't go out there. Whoa. Water on the floor. Spilt. What does that say? The refreshing mist. I like that. And a chair on the door. Refreshing mist and the chair will keep the zombies out. Again, good details in here. Now we're going to go through the door. Another excellent change of direction from the player path. I don't just walk right into this garage and it's not flat and level. Notice how I walk in, get to see the sign, see the car, and I'm like 4 steps up. 1, 2, 3, 4, maybe 5 steps up. I have to take a hard left and come down. And you even get a better view of the garage as you walk through it. More of the zombified people doing their strange half-alive actions. A lot of art, a lot of props in here. Fun little things like, hey, let's collect the ammo crate. Let me put this thing down. Oh, here we go. Here's another little, nice little addition to keep the player occupied. Oh! We have a little story stage set up here. This gentleman has smashed this person into the door and is not aware of it. This is definitely stuff a level designer, mission designer wants to add to his level. Put it in your list, write it up, see if the animators, the audio, the writers want to add to this and put this in the budget so it could fit in your level, fit in your mission. These are things that really make your mission come alive and sparkle. Makes the world feel deeper, bigger than just a series of halls and rooms with enemies popping up once in a while. And on this one, we get another little secret. Ooh, with a charred body. Tactician pack. Get an extra little bonus we can equip our guys with. Now we're in the back of the car dealership, and it truly is the back. You can see the sign up there, and if I hadn't shot down the alien balloon, it would be right there, and I could shoot it now, deflate it. Lots of space. I don't find any of this space really wasted. I think this space is good. My first video talked about that endless hallway that finally leads to the first battle, which I felt was wasted space and it was just completely unnecessary, but I find this little walk back here to be pretty cool. So as we walk through here, this is where we came from. Looks really good looking back. Garbage on the ground, dumpster. Happens if we shoot the trash. And what's that? Ooh, it moves. Very cool. Orange. Orange can. Rock. Gum. Cigarette. Oh, cigarettes blow up. Oh, papers move. Ooh. Box. Apple core. Alright, so even this stuff may be your job. They may have the art team placing this, but you may be in here.
He's on the AM bed.
Put it through.
XCOM, this is De Silva. If you can hear this, so can they. I'm dug in at the radio station. I have a few tricks up my sleeve, but I won't be able to hold them off for long. I could use backup.
If he's on an open broadcast,
they'll know right where he is.
I'm already seeing outsider activity.
They're moving on the radio station.
You heard the man, agents. Let's go.
So as a level designer, this is good. We are linear. We are creating a linear path. And as soon as I got near this gate or touched this gate, there is a trigger here. This trigger initiated the audio. And when that audio was done and those heads, as well as a little HUD pop-ups, showing those guys talk, the music changed. Notice how the music has gotten more tense. So as I was saying before, this may be your job as a level designer. Stage and set up all this garbage. Place it properly, make this area feel alive. Artists will do it as well. So you go through here, there's a lot of garbage, looks good in here. It's an abandoned lot, it's a really nice change of pace from the parking lot to this old truck, which is pretty beautifully modeled, pretty cool looking. This area doesn't feel dead at all, feels pretty alive and like I want to explore in here. This area might be getting excessive. Oh, what do we got here? Ammo! Little exploration. This might be getting a little excessive, all this stuff back here. You might want to put something more important back there than just ammo, but hey. Sometimes the artists are building bigger and badder stuff and faster than the designers can keep up. That's okay. So again, our player path is pretty interesting and cool. Walking through that gate, through this weed-encrusted area, up into this garage, which looks awesome. And notice how we don't go straight for that exit there. Notice how there's tables in the way, and they make us do this S-turn or U-turn. Very cool. Get to experience the smelly old garage. Look out the window. Can you see anything out there? Nope. That's where we're going. Lots of details in here to look around. What if we shoot stuff? Ah! There we go. Too bad there's no combat in this area. Oh yeah, there we go. Look at these bombs. Lots of bombs setting up. Pipe bombs. Ooh, what kind of details we got here? Timer setup. Even got drawings on how he's making the bombs. Alright, we're not walking straight again. We have to make another hard right. So this is where we talk about elevation changes, player path not always being straight, leading the player through interesting areas, even if they're just for making them feel like part of a bigger world. And this mission does that very well. And we hit our final door. And we're back into the lot again on the back side of this. Drop down. No backtracking. Can't go back there. This looks a little hokey. Don't go up the stairs. Alright, so this next section is great. We walk right into a really important moment here. Head over here.
We got hostiles!
Repositioning.
Get ready!
What the hell?
One of De Silva's surprises. He's close.
That's cool stuff. You feel like you just witnessed something really cool there. There's no way you can avoid it. I guess you could have made it a cutscene, but it's definitely cool that you encounter
Carter,
yourself.
Get in here. We don't have much time.
Come on, let's get to that station.
Yes, sir.
Alright, I'm just going to pause really quick because the combat can get out of hand. So, we walk right into that moment where the alien runs across us, takes cover, and boom! De Silva blows up the car. Great foreshadowing to, and also we had foreshadowing in the garage where we had the bombs laying around, a little diagram of how to make a bomb, which is getting pretty deep and pretty detailed and costs, you know, a lot of art time. But if you've got a big enough budget and you want to make sure the player is immersed in seeing that stuff, it totally helps. So you walk into that moment, it's great, and then we go around the corner, we're running to the action, and that cutscene feels appropriate. It sets us up right behind that car in the action. So sometimes a cutscene transition into the action works really well, and this one does. Sometimes you hit a cutscene, you're like, oh, I just wanted to run into the action and start blasting away. But it feels like this one's appropriate. So let's join the action, and now we have the ability to, when I bring up the pause my squad screen, where everything pauses and I give them orders, De Silva now had, I have the ability to tell De Silva to blow up bombs he's planted all over the place, which is pretty cool. So let's let the battle ensue, and just check out, everything's basically in a square with lots of cover points, all leading to the radio station where De Silva is. The goal, obviously, is to kill off the aliens and go talk to De Silva. So let's watch the action.
I left a few surprises for these assholes. Just say the word, and I'll set them off.
Here's De Silva view. Let's take out these three guys. Kaboosh!
De Silva, now!
Glad you're on our
side. Yeah!
Throw the charge, Nico.
Payback.
Select one left.
Pinned down.
Looks like we got a break. Meet me at the door.
Let's grab some ammo real quick. That was quick. Whoa. I didn't know you come out on this road quite well. Can you go over here too? Well, there's more space out there than I thought. I've always fought just in that contained area. Oh, there's more stuff over here. I like this. That's pretty cool. Alright, we'll see how this fight goes. I'm going to go talk to De Silva, who's not looking so good. This is pretty funny when I walk up to the door here. So the layout's great. I mean, it's very grid-like, but this feels like a courtyard for any old office building, mini mall, I don't know, something of that sort. Totally feels appropriate, and having the bombs planted and you being able to blow them up is great. It feels really fun. This is one of the better missions in the game. Oh, just click me in. Watch how he walks through the front door.
Carter, didn't think I'd see you again. See you again. See you. Stop. De Silva. Good Lord, what happened here? Where's the rest of your team? You're looking at it. We need to talk while I still can. You'd better come in. Shit. They've been looking for me for days. Better get ready.
So we're gonna repeat what we just did using the bombs, etc. We walk through the door after I mentioned the door. It's funny because it's all boarded up, and now, in the next moment, I walk through the door after I defeat these guys. I just kind of open the door, do 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 do. After it looks like it's a fortress in there, you just kind of push it open. All right, let's fight these guys.
Take him out.
This one's for Kenny. Payback.
Damn it, shields are up.
Call.
De Silva, now!
De Silva, now!
This one's for Kitty. Stay down.
Damn it, shields!
Lifting it! Take it out!
Got it!
What?
This one's fine! We're throwing shields, let's hit it!
Healing engaged.
Time to put up a diversion. Where should I divert? You guys can shoot over here for a while.
Set up a diversion.
Diversion out!
Let's target the drop
pod.
And let's target
finish it off.
Silva, now!
Blow the charge, Nico.
Watch it! They're coming for us!
I'm gonna blow up my squad mates. I don't care.
All right, Nico. Now, take him out.
Gunner, I'm down!
Oh, it's not doing anything to this guy.
I need help over here!
I heard you. I'm coming. Oh, jeez.
Help me!
It's not a good idea. Not a good idea. Run away. Run away. Alright. How's this guy doing? Let's heal.
Keep the pressure on him!
Any bombs there, this guy? Bombs didn't do anything, this guy.
De Silva, now! Set it up!
This, you fucks.
Is that another guy dead? No. I'm at a loss. What am I supposed to do?
Focus on that one.
Taking aim.
Hit it hard.
I wonder if this will do anything. Doubt it. Ooh. Dude,
taking the shot.
Ooh, that. Jeez, I'm out of ammo. Oh, come on! So close.
Need help here!
I got you.
Don't die, come on!
here. Come on, Commander.
Oh, you can do it. Let's go. Let's go.
Thanks. I needed that.
Where is he? Oh, jeez.
That's the right side.
You okay?
Repositioning.
Stay down.
Woo. That was close.
Barnes, man down. We need backup.
Roger. I'll see what I can do.
Whoa. Add to squad. Yay.
Help is on the
quick
way.
Bullets. Wrong bullet type.
I'm here to help, Commander.
That's it for now.
Alright, here's
inside.
The door part.
Copy, Nico.
We'll alright, that's quite an intense fight. I don't remember that big guy being that hard.
Copy that. Glad we found
I don't remember that guy being that tough, but we got through it. You can see the strategy of just circling this area and using those bombs works really well. You've got the tuning on this game is pretty good too, like the progression and tuning on when you have to use enemies, if you have to, I'm sorry, use your squad mates if you have to use them. You have to neutralize certain enemy types. If I didn't neutralize, and I'm trying to remember the name of him, he's a commander, he will shield other enemy types to make the situation much more difficult. And that heavy guy, you don't encounter that heavy guy as much as I'd like. He's pretty intense. Seems like you could have done more with him through this game. But really well set up. Circling this area using those bombs, super fun. One of the better missions in this. This whole sequence I'm playing here is one of the better missions. The art, the player path, the level design, very well done. And the combat setups are great. So this is funny. We walk through here and we just push the door open. No problem. Kanov. Again, the layout of this looks pretty good. Even that looks pretty good. Holes in the wall they're trying to cover up. Or I mean glass they're trying to cover. From here, we're going to meet De Silva. Lots of wood paneling. It's like a radio station.
Well, glad you made it.
I started to wonder if anyone was ever coming.
Will, I'm glad it was you they sent.
It's like he has melted grape jelly dripping out of his eyes.
Jesus. Look at you, Nico.
Yeah, you got me well. I can't fight it for long. But I'm doing what I can.
What can I do?
You can give those bastards a black eye for me. And for my team.
I promise you, Nico. They'll pay.
I know you're a man of your word, Will.
How do we get into the tower?
There's a warehouse behind the supermarket. The supermarket. Go down to the basement. They've dug a tunnel. It'll lead to the tower. The tower.
Is that it?
Yeah. Be careful in there, Carter. I don't know what they're doing in that tower, but they don't want us anywhere near it. Near it.
We can find a way to fix this, Nico. The scientists back at base.
Yeah, come on, Will. Don't bullshit me. There ain't a cure. And I'm not letting that creepy crowd poke at me looking for one.
Do you know how the infection started?
No. Or... I don't think I know. It's like trying to stay awake for a week. A week. I can barely think and I feel it right there. Right there. Trying to take over. But I'm not going down without a fight. Without a fight.
What kind of resistance can I expect?
Outside of the tower. Troops in emplacements. It'll be a hell of a fight. I can draw their attention away from you long enough for you. For you to slip past. But the real problem is getting inside.
You'll need to cut off the alarms once you're in. My team couldn't. Redmond and Kenny paid the price for that.
I'm sorry, Nico. It's time.
Yeah, I guess it is. So listen, I don't have a lot of ordnance left, but I can still do some damage and get him off your back for a couple of minutes while you slip through.
Are you talking about...
Yeah, Carter. I am. I'm not just gonna give up and turn on you or burn out. To hell with that. I'm a soldier. And I'm gonna die like one.
Nico.
Don't, Will. Just go. When you get to the gas station, signal me. It'll be a great show. A great show, Will. I know it's a long shot, but after all of this, if my boy shows up, tell him I'm sorry.
For what?
Just tell him. He'll know.
Okay, Nico.
Check out my fellow agent over here, loungily smoking. That was a pretty intense scene, and yet, yeah, whatever. Gonna have a smoke. Don't really care. Kind of funny. A lot of cool details in here. The layout of the town, some traps, posters, an old TV, bombs, oh, an old Coleman stove. Very cool. Well, this guy doesn't care either. Yeah, I'm smoking. There's a lot of cool cigarette smoke, though. Look at that. How much time did they spend making that cigarette smoke look good? Any secrets back here? Yep. It's a nice touch how he said, he kept repeating himself and drew attention, just like De Silva was doing there. Nice little story depth going on that he was starting to turn, maybe they didn't realize it, or be infected, might be the correct term. Headed for Leffelman's Supermarket. That's our clue. Leffelman's Supermarket. Little cool little setup here, surviving with three beds. Sleeping bags, lots of cans, flashlight. Nice touches. A lot of cool art and depth here. Something you'd see in Fallout where you could go around and investigate these areas over and over again and really appreciate it. You just kind of waltz through here. You'd never notice this unless you really take your time. So that conversation we had was important to show because that's part of the pacing of the mission. Us deciding as level designers, mission designers, game developers, when do we want that to happen? You know, where do we want to place these audio tapes, which the last one didn't play an audio tape, which is interesting. Where do we want to place those notes I just read? Here's another note. When do we want to encounter a main character like this and have a conversation where we get choices? Those are big decisions. If you do them too many in a row, it gets tedious. If you don't do enough of them, you lose track of the story. If you give them people too long of conversations, they're just going to skip through them and ignore all the details. So it's, again, part of our gig and our design to do it. So we've had that conversation. It was like a bookend to this mission. And I'm going to go out this door. And we see more people walking around like zombies. But there's an added bonus here. This is very important. And no, it's not the upgrade.
Weir, De Silva's going to create a distraction to draw them out. It should clear the way for us to get into the tower.
So we'll pick him up after?
No.
The bonus is not the basket.
He has other plans.
Not the basket. Not the bottle.
Oh,
Understood.
Not the apple. Not the bottle. Or this apple. Or this bottle. It's the hamburgers! Moldy hamburgers that fly. How far can we shoot the moldy hamburgers? Can we shoot these guys? Oh, you can shoot them. Oh! Wow, I don't remember shooting those guys. Sorry about that, buddy. Where's my moldy hamburger? I lost my moldy hamburger! Oh, no. My moldy hamburger's gone. Alright, that will be the end of this video. We're leaving you on a high note of moldy hamburgers. And I hope you appreciated it. And I think it's a good example of all the things we talk about in level design. Not making everything flat. Again, we have elevation change right here. Walk down. Very good. Not everything straight. Lots of details. Story elements, progression, pacing, combat setups. All right. Thank you for watching, and I will talk to you later. Bye-bye.